Hello everyone, my name is Zubair and I am excited to present my expense tracker project. With this project, users can create an account and manage their expenses. Additionally, our premium users can enjoy extra features such as checking the leaderboard and downloading expense reports. To develop this project for the front end, I utilize HTML, CSS and pure JavaScript. While for the backend, I use Node.js as the runtime environment, Express.js as the framework, and MySQL Workbench as the database. The best part in my project is, I store users' password in the database in hashed form of the data by bcrypt library. I am authorizing users to perform action or to do API calls using token which is generated using JSON Web Token. Implemented forget password and generate reset password link used sendinblue. By sendinblue, we send that link to the email. By clicking that link, user can change his password. I have integrated Razorpay as a payment gateway to deal with premium transactions. I have used Amazon Web Service S3 bucket to generate and download reports. This feature is only available for premium users. I also deploy this project on AWS Cloud, configured with Nginx and Jenkins. So I am thinking you all are the interested in my project. So let's jump inside my project. So let me open my VS Code first. This is my expense tracker project. Here you can see this is the controller which is associated with the respective routes. There's a front-end folder which holds all my front-end files. There's a middleware folder which is the part of the user authentication. And there's a models folder which holds all the tables which I am creating by the SQLize method. And there's a package.json which holds all the important package which I have needed in this project. So yeah, this is it. Let me start my server first. So yeah, it's but before that I have to check my workbench. Let me check it and refresh the table. It is created any table. So by default there is a no table existing. So whenever our server has been successfully run, it created all the table dynamically. So wait a minute, it should be created after 3 or 4 seconds. Yeah, it is creating now. You can see there is a user table, forget password table has been created. Let me refresh it over here and check it. Yeah, you can see over here that all the tables are created one by one. Expense table, forget password table, user table, orders table, all the tables are created now. And all the tables fields is empty. There is a no data here. You can see over here. So now it's time to jump inside my front end part in the Chrome browser. So let me open it. So let me show my front end part. Because I am run on the 3000 port, so let me run it. So it's redirect me on the slash page. So slash page is a error page, so there is a nothing showing over here. By click me, I will redirect on the login.html page, which is the login page. So here you can see this is login page, but there is a no user existing, so let me sign up first. So I am just putting 3 or 4 random users. So let me put it some users, email ID, name and password. Make sure each and every time email should be unique. So yeah, I have created 4 users successfully. So before jump inside my expense page, let me check my workbench. Is there all the users have been created or not? So here you can see now users table is populated with a respective name, email ID, password, and password is stored in the encrypted format with the help of the bcrypt library, and is premium of all users by default is false. So it's time to my check forget password functionality. So let's check it out. So by clicking the forget password, I will jump inside my forget password page, and I am sending link at the Zubair8960. Let's see it. So I have sent mail successfully. Let's check my Gmail. I have got this mail with the help of the send in blue. So it's opening. So yeah, I have got this mail successfully. So let me open this mail. Here you can see there is a reset password link. By clicking that link, I will jump inside my another form, which is where I was enter the new password and the reset password button. By clicking the reset password button, our password will be changed and it will be redirected on the login page. So it's redirected. Let me sign in by the Zubair with the password 1234. Let me check it. So yeah, pop-up comes. I have logged in successfully. So it's time to the expense page. Let me check it out. So this is my expense tracker main website, where you can see there's a top corner, there's a buy premium button, and the right corner, top right corner, there's a name of the user. Bottom there's a logout button, and in the front of the screen there's a form. So there's all other things you are not able to see because this user is not a premium. So let me entering some expenses of the Zubair first. So I am just putting any random details for the populated his expense. So just a minute. So yeah, I have created all the expenses. So it's time to check my workbench. Is there a expense table is populated or not? So let me check my expense table. So here you can see now expense table is also be populated with the respective user's expense. There is a user ID is now a foreign key over here, and this is working fine. Now it's time to check my pagination part. So each page have the limited item per page. So let me set it by the 2 item per page. So if I just set 2 item, then you can only see the 2 expenses per page, and each page are the different item from each other. So this is all the working fine. It's time for the delete expense. So when we delete the expense, it also be deleted from the database and the front end both as well. So if I just refresh the space, then it's also be working fine. So let me check. Yeah, it's also be working fine. I did not getting the same data. So let me do the same operation for the different user. So I am just opening in the incognito window. So let me do the same things over here. So just a minute. So here I am just trying to signing by the ABC site. So let me signing by the ABC email ID and password. So here I am just enter the expense page of the ABC. So let me enter some expense because ABC is also don't have any prior expenses. So wait a little bit more. So yeah, I have created approximately 5 expenses. This is all the working fine, and pagination is also be okay. Let me check it. So yeah, it's also be working fine. And if we just try to delete any expenses, let me check it. Yeah, deleted successfully. So all the features are working fine. Let me introduce one more important feature in my project, which is the premium user. So let me do it. So by clicking the buy premium button, I should be the premium member. So here you can see there is another window open. There is a Razor Pay payment window where we have to pay 100 rupees. And there I have nothing to worry about that, because this is only for the trial purpose. And here I am just choosing ICICI Bank to pay, and by clicking success, we have just become the premium member. So yeah, here you can see now I am the premium user. So I can see some extra features such as show leaderboard, download files and show previous downloaded files. So this is okay, fine. Now check me by workbench. So now here you can see the is premium column, user in the premium member. So this is working fine. Now check me show leaderboard. So here you can see all the user's name and his expenses, total expenses. So yeah, this is okay, fine. By clicking the show leaderboard, this is also be displayed. So let me hide it. By clicking the show downloaded files, we able to see all the files which I have downloaded previously. So because I have no file downloaded till now, so I have to download it now. So it's downloading. So yeah, now file have been successfully downloaded. So let me open this file. So this file is populated with the expenses, user's expenses, which he has created till now. So this is it. Let me close this file. So now I will just click the show downloaded files. Then you can see the URL along with the time date. And if I do it again, so I can I am able to see it again. So you are able to see two URL over here. So this is it. I implemented overall these thing in my project. So yeah. So let me do the same feature with the ABC users in the incognito window. Let me do ABC also as a prime member. So it's opening Razor Pay payment window where we can pay 100 rupees. So I am just also this is also be the trial purpose. So nothing to worry about it. And if we just success it, now ABC is also be the prime member. Pop up comes now. Yeah, there is all the things okay. If I just click the show downloaded files, it's also be working fine. So leaderboard, sorry. So it's okay. Show downloaded files, it's also be working fine. And yeah, all the features are same like that. So this one more thing that if I just click the and check my file downloaded tables, then this is also be populated with the respective URL and respective user ID. So this is okay, fine. So yeah, this is it. So one last thing, I also deployed my project on AWS cloud. I hosted there. So let me open my URL. So here you can see, let me log in over here. So here you can see this is also be working fine, and it's working same like that which I have explained earlier. So yeah, this is okay. So this is all about my project. I also attached my GitHub link in the description. You can check it out there. And thank you all for your patience and giving me your important times. I will catch you all in the next video. Thank you all.